Jesus Christ is our hope. Jesus Christ is our hope for peace. Because of Christ, we can have the joy that is promised in God's word. This candle represents love, because Christ loves us enough to come to earth so that all people can be saved. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
And blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Purify our conscience, Almighty God, by your daily visitation, that your Son, Jesus Christ, at his coming, may find in us a mansion prepared for himself, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen. A reading from the second book of Samuel. Now when the king was settled in his house, and the Lord had given him rest from all his enemies around him, the king said to the prophet Nathan, "See now, I am living in a house of cedar, but the ark of God stays in a tent." Nathan said to the king, "Go, do all that you have in mind, for the Lord is with you." But that same night, the word of the Lord came to Nathan, "Go and tell my servant David, thus says the Lord, are you the one to build me a house to live in? I have not lived in a house since the day I brought up the people of Israel from Egypt to this day, but I have been moving about in a tent and a tabernacle. Wherever I have moved about among all the people of Israel, did I ever speak a word with any of the tribal leaders of Israel, whom I commanded to shepherd my people Israel, saying, 'Why have you not built me a house of cedar?' Now therefore, thus you shall say to my servant David, thus says the Lord of hosts, I took you from the pasture, from following the sheep to be prince over my people Israel, and I have been with you wherever you went, and have cut off all your enemies from before you. And I will make for you a great name, like the name of the great ones of the earth. And I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, so that they may live in their own place and be disturbed no more, and evildoers shall afflict them no more. As formerly, from the time that I appointed judges over my people Israel, and I will give you rest from all of your enemies. Moreover, the Lord declares to you that the Lord will make you a house. Your house and your kingdom shall be made sure forever before me. Your throne shall be established forever." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Now to God, who is able to strengthen you according to my gospel and the proclamation of Jesus Christ, according to the revelation of the mystery that was kept secret for long ages but is now disclosed, and through the prophetic writings is made known to all the Gentiles, according to the command of the eternal God to bring about the obedience of faith to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who is said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be according to your word." The angel departed from her. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Good morning. Last Sunday, Father McKee, Steve, shared the reflection of Meister Eckhart, 13th century theologian and mystic from Germany, on the incarnation, and it has haunted me since. Richard Rohr relates that his friend and fellow theologian Matthew Fox translates Eckhart's words thus: "What good is it to me if Mary gave birth to the Son of God 1,400 years ago, and I do not give birth to the Son of God in my own person and time and culture? We are all meant to be mothers of God." Think on that. Mothers of God. I think we often forget just how much God is counting on us, how much God depends on us. There would have been no incarnation, no redeemer, no redemption, but for the courage of Mary to will what God wanted for the world, that it be reconciled to God and justice and peace live together. It took a mother's work to raise such a man as Jesus. And listening to her Magnificat, no one can doubt her commitment and her zeal for justice and her desire for peace. But we know also of her great compassion, of her willingness to bear the sufferings of Jesus with no animosity against her own people or the Romans, as she endured with him below his cross. But as Meister Eckhart reveals, the redemption must be ministered to every age and culture. It is not a static, unchanging reality, but a living, dynamic one. Jesus of Nazareth, the great sacrifice for the cause of immortal love, is unending while the world lasts. We celebrate this constant presence of the risen Christ when we call upon the Holy Spirit in the Eucharistic prayer at the altar of Christ, and now commit to go out into the world, as we pray in our after communion prayer, to do the work we have been given to do. One with Mary, we choose to bear God into the world. Advent is the time of the coming of God into our lives. This happens every day. Every hour that God needs us to minister God's grace to a hurting, frightened world. A world that has suffered so much in this past year. It will happen in our homes, at our place of work, in the common meeting of one human being with another, in our love and care for the creation, and yes, in the moment of our death, and one day, the end of the world. God is always coming into the world, speaking the word of love. This is both a great challenge to us and our greatest comfort and hope. Mary is us, and we are Mary. She is indeed a blessed lady. Let us all pray together the ancient prayer based on the words of the angel who brought her God's plea. Hail Mary, full of grace. The Lord is indeed with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people are Form 3, found on page 387 of the Book of Common Prayer and in your service leaflet. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, we pray for mission agencies and their ministry throughout the Anglican Communion, including the Mothers' Union around the world. In the diocesan cycle of prayer, we pray for St. Peter and All Saints Episcopal Church, Kansas City, Missouri, and the diocesan surviving spouses. Look graciously on your church, and so guide the minds of those who shall choose a rector for this parish, that we may receive a faithful pastor who will care for your people and equip us for our ministries. Father, we pray for your holy Catholic Church.
That we all may be one.
Grant that every member of the church may truly and humbly serve you.
That your name may be glorified by all people.
We pray for Michael, our presiding bishop, Martin, our bishop, and for all bishops, priests, deacons, and laity.
That they may be faithful ministers of your word and sacraments.
We pray for Donald, the president, Joe, the president-elect, and all who govern and hold authority in the nations of the world.
That there may be justice and peace on the earth.
Give us grace to do your will in all that we undertake.
That our works may find favor in your sight.
Have compassion on those working to protect us during this pandemic and on Liesl, Alan, Eileen, Georgine, Ryan and his family, Matt, Jordan and Ashley, Kathy, Renee, Petrina, Ben, Gwen, Michael, Karen, Carol and Bruce, Esben, Bridget and Mike, Adrian, on all those who reach out to St. Paul for prayers, and all those who suffer from any grief or trouble.
That they may be delivered from their distress.
Give to George, Brianna, Ahmed, Jacob, the victims of the current pandemic, and all those departed, eternal rest.
Let light perpetual shine upon them.
We praise you for your saints who have entered into joy.
May we also come to share in your heavenly kingdom.
We give you thanks for this whole parish and for this family gathered online this morning. Let us pray for our own needs and those of others, especially our food ministries, the people of South Sudan, Holy Cross School, Haiti, St. Paul's Day School, Gordon Park School, and Citizen of the World Academy. We invite now your thanksgivings, intercessions, and petitions, silently or aloud.
Give thanks for Emma and for Lindsay. O Lord our God, accept the fervent prayers of your people. In the multitude of your mercies, look with compassion upon us and all who turn to you for help. For you are gracious, O lover of souls, and to you we give glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Peace. 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 Good morning, everyone. I am Jonathan Callison here at St. Paul's, along with Steve McKee and Director of Music Sam Anderson and the lovely Sarah, who's also with us today. And we are so glad that you have decided to join us for worship today. If you are a visitor this morning, please take a moment to say hello in the comments and come to coffee hour following the service. Our weekly newsletter is available by subscription and on our website. Please read it over for important information about our prayer and study small groups and the special music, worship, and holiday activities coming soon. Pledges are coming in at a nice rate, and there is still time to get yours in to get counted. Please do so at your earliest convenience. Please plan to join us Christmas Eve online at 5 p.m. A goodie bag will be delivered prior to the service with the service bulletin and some other fun things.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you sent your beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and to make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may, without shame or fear, rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Oh,
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation. In the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. When he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where with Mary, Paul, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. The gifts of God for the people of God. Whoever you are and wherever you find yourselves on your journey of faith, all are welcome to receive communion this morning at God's altar here at St. Paul's Church.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we thank you for feeding us through the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and for assuring us in these holy mysteries that we are living members of the body of your Son and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do, to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. May Almighty God, by whose providence our Savior Christ came among us in great humility, sanctify you with the light of his blessing and set you free from all sin.
Amen.
May he whose second coming in power and great glory we await make you steadfast in faith, joyful in hope, and constant in love.
Amen.
May you who rejoice in the first advent of our Redeemer at his second advent be rewarded with unending life.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
As we await our coming Savior, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ, amen.